So my goal here today is to give you a simple template to follow in order to master any hero so that you can climb in competitive. Because the most important thing, especially below Diamond, is your performance on a hero. I had some help with this template from GM players, so thanks to them for that. We usually do one of two things, either flex to whatever the team needs, or play one or two heroes and refuse to switch. The issue with one tricking is obvious. You limit your options to the point where if the enemy counters you, there's nothing you can do to help your team. The issue with flexing is that you are playing heroes that you have little experience with or think you are good at when really you're just decent with them at your current rank. The truth is that it requires a bit of both flexing and sticking with certain heroes. The first thing you have to accept, myself included, just because like you, I love playing most of the heroes in the game, is that you can only truly master between 3 and 6 heroes. Yes, I know we can play 90% of the heroes and we are the ultimate flex player, but the list I'm about to give you is going to let you know if you really are a master at that hero. First, know your objective. And I don't mean the map objective, I mean the objective for your individual hero. First for any hero is learning how to get your ultimate fast, by any means. Like with the new Hanzo, I constantly forget to use the Storm Arrows, which would lend me a lot more Dragon Strikes if I use them more frequently. So remember, the first thing with any hero is learning the most efficient way to obtain your ult quickly. Your second objective has to do with your specific role, such as flanking, healing, getting picks, or creating space. Break your hero's objective down into simple steps and you'll always know what to do with them. For example, with Sombra, my main objectives are to get my EMP fast, hack either a tank or healer, contest the objective, and distract the backline. By keeping these things in mind, I know I'm always doing my job, and I don't try to do another person's job. The next thing is know your ideal positioning and respect it. I think many players know good positioning in theory, but in practice constantly sacrifice good positioning for a variety of reasons, myself included. It could be to finish off a low health target and you tunnel vision, or you want to reposition to a high risk, high reward position, like a flanking McCree, and usually it ends up bad for you. And even because you simply don't think taking high ground is that big a deal. But let me tell you as a side note, it is a huge deal, and you're probably doing it wrong if you think it's not. Because you have to use it as cover. If you're standing at the edge of the high ground, then you're right, it's not really an advantage because you're exposing yourself just as if you were on the low ground. But anyways, good positioning goes well with map knowledge, which is the next thing on this list. Knowing the best spots for your hero and how to take advantage of these spots are crucial for hero mastery. Mobile heroes tend to be easier when it comes to navigating the map, but low mobility heroes need to learn to use the environment for cover. Sure, you can try and depend on your Rein to hold the shield, but even a good Rein has to make sure he has something to get behind when his shield gets broken. So, with low mobility heroes especially, you have to make sure you have an escape and some cover available at all times, but also be within sight of the enemy so you can do your job. Also, know where the health packs are, especially if you're a flanker, and the routes your hero can take to get a good sightline on the enemy. Next for mastering any hero is to know every single matchup for your hero in the game. This part does take time and experience, but it needs to be done for you to consider yourself a master on that hero. You need to be comfortable on an instinctual level on what to do whenever you come across X hero. When you don't know your matchups, you'll play Tracer and walk into the face of a Junkrat without thinking about it, or have a long range battle with a Widow as a Pharah. You need to know what to do against all the heroes. I think we all know Carq's video series is perfect for this, so I recommend watching those. Make sure to find a top 500 player that plays your hero and watch their Twitch stream. You can learn so much by watching them live and not in a YouTube video montage. Plus, you can ask them questions. My Sombra skyrocketed once I started watching Fitzy. You're not going to reinvent the wheel with whatever hero you're trying to master, so just know there's already a top 500 player that plays the hero you want to master and watch them. They will teach you little tricks with that hero that no one who casually plays them will use, such as shooting Orisa barriers in the air so that your barrier usage nearly doubles during a match. Or as Sombra, knowing that after you throw your translocate and you're waiting for it to go really far away from you, to use that time to initiate your invis animation, that way when you teleport, you're already running at full speed. Those little tricks will take you to the next level, so learn them. And finally, review your own gameplay. During the match, you have to pay attention to a lot of things, especially if you are learning a new hero. So that means you will miss a lot in the moment as well, so going back may seem tedious because you already know what happened and don't need to see it again. But I guarantee there will be something you missed, and seeing that will make sure you make those mistakes less next time. Hope this helps you guys out. What do you think it takes to master any hero in the game? Do you feel I missed something, or was there something you didn't think about before this video? I'd love to know in the comments. If you would like some coaching from me or help from any other coaches, please join our Discord where everyone is friendly and there is no rank judgment. We will also host console scrims every week to help others improve, so be sure to show up for that. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to share, like, and subscribe to the channel. My name is Chit, and I approve this message.